There's so many things to consider when you're thinking about all this weight loss. Hey, it doesn't matter how old you are. We have lots to think about when we change our diet or when we add on our physical aspects, meaning working out. Maybe you're one of those people that are just doing it for the first time or haven't done it in a long time, whatever the case. But there's really one thing that you should think about once you begin your journey on weight loss over 50. You guys know me pretty well, and for those of you that are new to the channel, welcome to Reg Edited. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and get the notifications at the same time so you can be sure that I do upload a video, God willing, every week. So my husband has the belief system of the good old-fashioned way about losing weight. Bottom line, burn more calories that you take in. And for him, he rides the bike daily and at least 30 to 40 miles a day. And so for him, yes, he's burning like crazy, probably 800 to 1,000 calories. And then he eats two meals a day. And of course, he drops the weight like no tomorrow. And for me, just to get the 5 pounds that I want to get rid of, that is really bothering me in that middle section. I think you guys know, I'm almost 52 now, so being at this age of the menopausal phase, like, painful. I know it's painful for you guys. I know it's painful for me. I can tell that it's just a struggle. You can't starve yourself. And people think that I'm starving myself because I usually eat one meal a day. That's not true all the time. If you think about it, there's so many things that go into structuring the diet that works for you. Is it the right time that the diet is actually working in your favor? I'll tell you what I mean. So we always talk about what we should eat, and then we talk about what we should not eat, all in the name of losing weight. And it's different for everyone. We have to figure out what is your sweet spot. And it doesn't mean that my diet is going to be the same for you. And because we have so many things going on in the body, then we have to adjust to what the body will actually respond to. The one thing that I cannot teach is to find the foods that you actually enjoy. You have to do kind of a trial and error and find out what your body feels really good with and what you enjoy, because if you don't enjoy these certain foods, you're not going to continue on the diet that you chose for yourself, and it's just not going to be sustainable, right? One thing that is consistent is that the body changes all the time, and as we age especially, what diet may have worked, say, 5 years ago, even 3 years ago, may not work as good, say today, in what your body is now. Your cells are changing. The body is always doing something to repair itself. And you want to make sure that you are nutritionally giving it what it needs. So if you're deficient in certain areas, such like myself, I'll give you an example. I usually eat a early dinner, which is around 4 or 5, 5:30, depending on my day at work. Usually I'm not hungry in the mornings or even in the afternoons. But lately, in the last couple of months, I've noticed that I'm starting to get hungry in the mornings. And I'm like, okay, what's that about? So I would do my normal to curb the appetite. I would drink my apple cider vinegar drink with squeezed lemon. And then I thought about it more, and I talked to other people that are in the nutritional field, and they share with me that my body is thirsting for certain nutrients that it might be deficient in. And that's what clicked in my head. I needed flavonoids, so I ate some fruit in the mornings, and you know what? I didn't feel guilty this time. Usually I would feel guilty because I'm breaking my fast earlier than I like to, but we can't always do the same intermittent fasting schedule all the time. Sometimes you got to kick it up a little bit. Sometimes you got to shorten the eating window. But then sometimes you need to extend it so you can get in all the good nutrients that you're looking to do and what the body is requiring. So with my one meal, I know the audience has asked, how do you get all your veggies in? You know, the recommended amount of veggies are like 6 to 9 cups, which is impossible for me even if I ate 3 meals a day. So that's why I have to do supplements and have to make up for these things. I may have to do some juicing. So juicing is good because you're getting quite a large amount of fruits and vegetables in, but you just have to look at it from that standpoint. At the same time, there's still portion control in some cases. Yes, if you're eating whole foods 80 to 90% of the time and it's plant-based, yes, you would require a lot more veggies and you would try and get that all in. So you can look at it from that standpoint. If you tend to eat some meat, which I do periodically, I do have fish a couple times a week and the occasional eggs. But if it's something that you do and you're eating clean meat, whole foods, then you know you have to adjust how much you're going to eat. You have to be portion control. And so for instance, we're looking at our fists when you look at meat, and that's kind of the guideline. So maybe between 3 to 5 ounces tops that you would have meat. And then I'm cutting the carbs, meaning I'm not having a bunch of starch. And then I would have vegetables with it only. And that's still carbs, but it's green and it's the nutrients that my body's looking for if I'm going to have meat in this case. I noticed something in the past week or two that I was starving for more protein and I was starving for more flavonoids. So I was needing vitamin C, vitamin A. You know, these are the things that the body will tell you, and it's pretty smart. You just need to figure out what are those nutrients that your body is asking for, and then take note. The one thing I always say is take note if something different occurred in a certain week or any given day that you would not normally eat that way. Take note of that because you have to realize you are searching for more vitamins, more nutrients, more minerals that we have been depleted of if we have been in diet mode for a long time. I have to take a break from dieting and I have to take a break from the whole intermittent fasting schedule because I've been doing it for like 3 years now. And I can say that I haven't really taken a real break longer than say a week off of intermittent fasting. We know that's not a diet, but it's the timing and it's the amount of food that I'm intaking. And so I'm plateauing. And you just have to kind of shock the body a little bit and do something different that it doesn't expect, but also give it the nutrients that it's asking for. Listen to your body. So the one thing to think about, it's the mental aspect of how the body is going to respond to your changing of your diet. So again, I was eating fish one other day that was like midweek. I had fish and I had spinach and mushrooms, and that was pretty much it, but it was very satiating. I made sure I had my probiotics the night before I went to bed. And you know what? My stomach was really flat when I woke up. It really was. So I'm like, there's something to this. There's something to this. It's okay to change your schedule around. If you want to do high carbs, that's fine. As long as your body is responding, even if you do carb cycling, so where you're eating a bunch of carbs, if you are athletic and you are doing a harder workout of some sort, then you might want to carb up. So that's giving you more energy to burn, and then you eventually will be burning the fat. With the meats, the proteins, and the fats, you might want to check your macros and see what that looks like. I had to adjust mine as well. I had to up a little bit of the protein and I up a little bit of the fat to make sure that the body is getting what it's asking for. So that's what I wanted to share with you. It wasn't really anything scientific, but it's just about listening to your body, take note, and remember that you may be deficient in certain areas that we have to really focus on and give it what it's asking for. even if you're falling off of an intermittent schedule or you're doing something different and just eating more in certain days, that's okay because the body is going to pay you back of what you give it that is in the positive. So the question I might ask you is, are you deficient in certain ways and certain vitamins or certain minerals? And if you are you willing to adjust your diet? I thank you so much for watching. And don't forget that I'm on Instagram. Come check me out over there at RegEdited. And I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. And don't forget that caregiving begins with you. And you know what? We are still searching for the perfect bite and balance.